You know, it's funny. I think it's always the same for me. You don't really know what the show is going to be like until you get there. The thing that's wild is how different shows can be with just the tweak of a venue and what it calls for and what kind of show you put on and what kind of connect there is with the audience. I'm so fucking romantic. The beautiful thing about traveling is you're constantly exposed to so much different that you can't help but be influenced by it. For me, influences, it's all shapes and sizes. You know, I like to constantly write ideas down and sing little melodies into my phone or whatever. And it's almost like you're standing in a field with a lightning rod, hoping lightning strikes. You can't really take too much credit for it. You just kind of show up, you know? My camera going off. I'll be a paparazzi all night long. Splash. Cultures are so different and places are so different, but music is the universal language, you know, and it's an incredible thing to experience that, but to also see the differences and what songs they react to and see the differences within, you know, the 24 hours you are in a place and can grasp as much as you can from the culture, be it the food, the conversation, or the just the beat of the city. Fucking romantic, that you can't even handle it. It's the big joke that you're on stage for 90 minutes or you're on stage for an hour and all the rest of the days are spent getting there to that hour on stage because it is that much of a high. I'm the world's most simple traveler. I like my blanket. I don't even need a pillow. I got this terrible pose in a window seat with legs up. It's really bad. It's probably doing my back no good. I'll realize that in like 10 years and be like, I wonder why I can't walk anymore. As long as I have that and some good snacks, I'm a happy guy. Cash, raining on us, designer clouds and beds wide.